show number 623. My name is Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson, here with Mr. Jeff Rubenstein.
Hello, Jeffrey.
Hi.
Hello.
We're back.
We are, and I have a little bit of a head cold.
You know what? Everybody that I know has come back from E3, they left a little piece of themselves down there in L.A.
Or I took something with me from L.A.
Well, look, mass is neither created nor destroyed.
And today's physics class is brought to you by Dr. Rubenstein. Thank you.
My mom is so proud.
Yeah, you were paying attention to that class. We're back after E3. It's what a show that was. What a week.
That was my favorite E3. That was my 12th E3, and it was my favorite. I'm just saying it. It's coming from the heart. I really enjoyed this E3. I love the space we were in. I love the show. It's hard for you.
Yeah, it is, because there's so many years that I've been doing it. That one in Santa Monica was delightful.
That was my first.
That was your first. We talked about that on the video show we did. Announcing Xbox 360, Xbox One, having the Beatles on stage.
I was there.
I know Laura would. You were at the Beatles here?
I was there.
Were you sitting for that one? Did we talk about this?
So you know where the roof is?
Yep.
My hair was touching it.
Okay.
That was back when I was a Sony, and people know, like, people
detente.
From different companies
right.
will go over to see whatever else you're doing.
It's a gentleman's agreement.
Yeah.
You come to our show, we'll go to your show.
Exactly. And so I was there, and you guys set me up with the great view, an aerial view. I felt like I was watching from the blimp. And, but it was pretty incredible to see the Beatles.
Yeah. Right. You can see the breakaways, form from up. Oh, never mind. It's not hockey.
What?
The high, I don't know.
Oh,
I,
yeah, yeah. Whenever it's you're good from a higher view.
Right,
yeah.
Hockey's always greater from
it's
a higher
view. It's terrible on TV.
So, but yeah, I'll agree. It was definitely one of the top five, if not one of the top shows that we've had. And just in terms of announcements, the sheer tonnage, the fun, the goodwill, the vibe, to your point, the new venue. We were at the Microsoft Theater, which is right there in the middle of all the action.
And we just had so many people. There was the most amount of people we've ever had.
Almost 7,500.
Which was crazy. And actually, I was sitting rather high up this time, you know, with the employee section. We want to give the fans, with the media and all the other attendees, you know, the close-up seats. But it was actually cool sitting in the sort of like in the back of the theater on the upper deck and just hearing the sound envelop.
So let me tell you, did we talk about this story on air?
I don't think we did.
Okay, so when I was watching the show, we were backstage in a workroom. I have a desk. I've got a wired connection so I can monitor what's going on. We've got a house feed of what's going on.
You were in the command center.
In the command center. So the show opens. Phil comes out. Did Phil come out at the top of the show?
No. The very first thing
right.
was Halo Infinite.
Right. Okay. So there we go. So Halo Infinite, the trailer plays. And it's playing. We're getting it on the screen. I'm seeing Twitter light up, and everything's happening, and this is great. And then, so I'm sitting in this back room, on probably the second floor. So we're probably behind the stage a little bit off. You remember this?
Yeah.
Anyway, Chief's helmet goes down, and I don't hear a thing. I hear no crowd noise.
Really?
And I'm like, uh-oh. And I go running out there, and I open that side door, you know, this, and I'm literally, my hair is blown back by the applause and the excitement. So it turns out the room we were in, even though we were less than 100 feet away from the theater, you know, 7,500 people whooping it up, was completely soundproof. Number two,
professional theater.
The feed we had didn't have any audio from the audience.
Oh, so you were just hearing what was coming through the switcher or whatever.
Right, right. We were just hearing, in this case, the trailer.
Yep.
So I thought I was like, uh-oh. And then I ran out there and I realized that, okay, this is, because it was right at the top of the show, so he hadn't had a chance to figure out to realize that yet. So that was it was a great theater.
There's a ton of like great reaction videos, and there were some were filmed like on like a cell phone from in the crowd. I'll link out to these reaction videos.
I don't really.
Sometimes reaction videos are great. I'm not talking, actually some of them are good. You know, when you have like very, you know, emotional or very like excitable people, seeing how they react to stuff is really funny.
Like, so you should do a reaction video of me drinking European Diet Coke.
No, I,
Coke
yes.
Light.
Yes, that's exactly, we're filming that at Gamescom this year. Provided we're together in Germany, I am looking forward to, we will do a Coke Light Vine 2, whatever it's called. Actually, are you on the Instagram
yes.
TV? IGTV, the new thing they announced?
I got asked to be a part of that, and so I have to be careful where I appear. I just want to make sure.
We don't want to overexpose.
No, I want to make sure it's right. So
no, on every can of Coke Light sold in Italy and Germany, all of Central Europe. Well, I think we should do that. But anyway, I there was some great reaction stuff, and just feeling the energy in the arena at that point.
Was that
just,
was on Sunday.
Yeah, chills. It lasted for like 20 minutes.
This is the second year we've done Sunday, and apparently it's working well. It works for a lot of people. It's a little more, you know, it's the weekend people.
You're underselling it a bit.
Okay, give me the numbers.
I'm going to bring it up, but I believe it was like the most viewed live stream concurrent like ever on Twitch, something
right.
to that effect. Like it was 1.something million,
right?
Which is, well, that's crazy.
Yeah, in fact, you've got the numbers in front of you, right? You've got it somewhere.
Well, I'm bringing it up.
Yeah, so it was a big show. It was a big show. I'm waiting for you to bring that up.
I know.
Quiet.
Oh, man. Well, I saw a story that said that.
Yeah,
now I gotta look
I tweeted it.
Oh, here we go. This is Screen Rant, so, you know, judge as you will, and a couple others, but Xbox E3 2018 conference was the highest watched live stream ever on Twitch.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, it's bigger than pretty much anything. So, and it was a good show. We had a good show. Phil's always great. You know, He just, I know you talk to him all the time. I talk to him all the time.
Sometimes.
I stop by his office. It's great. I have the ability. I always have this weird ability where I just drift into someone's office and sit down and start talking to them.
Yeah.
And you've seen it happen.
People love it. Let me just tell you, everyone loves it.
But
when you darken their doorway.
I can't tell if you're being facetious or not.
Not me.
But Phil's great. You know, I stopped and he chatted and it was great. The thing I'm bummed, we normally do a pre-E3 podcast and we couldn't do it this year.
Yeah, we did.
No. I'm sorry, with Phil.
Oh, with Phil.
Yeah. Yeah, normally we're down in his dressing room and we do something, but it was moving so fast and the show is, you know, we're rehearsing and want to make sure it's great.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we did get to speak with Phil on a Mixer cast, maybe like a month out.
Yeah. Right. And, we had him come by.
You know, it's always better to talk to him afterwards when we can talk about the actual things.
Yeah.
You know,
five new studios.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So. We got to go visit them. I want to get out there to Compulsion and Quebec and Ninja Theory and when the initiative gets off the ground in Santa Monica.
I had a great chat
there.
With Daryl about that. The new lead of that. And we're going to do that when he's ready to go. I did chat with Guillaume.
Yep.
From Compulsion. And mm-hmm. he basically said, go away until they're shipped. which is soon. Right, which is soon. And you and I have heard that before.
Few. Yeah.
You know, you got to stay out of the way because they got a
deadline. They're right there in the home stretch. But looking forward to finally seeing We Happy Few. You know, we saw it when it first came into game preview. And there wasn't a heck of a lot more at that point 2 years ago than was like on the floor at E3. But
right.
There's a lot more that's come up. So we're actually going to work on some content to let everyone know, hey, here's what's changed in the last 2 years. If you picked it up, because it was like a week after E3 two years ago. And we got like that very early access. But now, you know, there's a lot more to it.
We had talked about that. We talked about our good friends at Playground Games coming on board.
Forza Horizon 4 looks so good.
Right.
So good.
Now, we've got Graham Boyd coming. When I got Forza, I have to legally talk about Graham in the same sentence because he's such a Forza head. He's going to join us in just a minute. He's on his way over from the other side
Excellent.
Of campus.
And then the last one, of course, is the makers of State of Decay 2, which I'm hearing sold very well. And that's Undead Labs right in downtown Seattle.
That's the second to the last one.
Did I not? I said.
What about our friends?
I said Ninja Theory.
Oh, I didn't hear you say Ninja Theory.
That was the first one out of
I'm
my
sorry.
Mouth.
I'm sorry. You know. Now you know why.
You really do have a head cold.
I do. You can hear it in me. I feel terrible. But Jeff said we have to do a show, and I agreed with him because we want to get in here. We want to talk about E3. We want to talk about the summer's underway. You know, we're recording this on the first day of summer.
The longest day of the year.
Which year,
sun will set at like 3 in the morning and rise at 3:15.
It's all downhill from here.
Practically, and that's true.
Right.
It is sort of like when you live in like a really northern latitude, when you feel the days get longer, there's just sort of a sense of optimism.
It feels so good.
Now we're in the slow slide to
oblivion.
Know, to darkness.
Darkness. Yeah. Anyway, darkness, so got a bunch of great stuff coming up there. Jeff and I did Inside Xbox. Well, you know, we should talk about what we're playing because Graham.
Let's do that. Let's get back in a normal show.
Let's get
back
to a normal show. We're talking about what we're playing. What are you playing? Because I got some good stuff.
Quite a bit. So actually, when I came back, I was excited about a few things. Ubisoft had a couple of great announcements that we saw. And one of them was The Division 2.
Yep.
And I had realized that we actually played a lot of The Division. We talked about it actually on the live cast. But I'd never like fully, I think I was one mission short and I never actually finished. And I never fully upgraded the base, the mail room or whatever that building is there in Midtown. So I jump back in, they added a shields mechanism and I learned very quickly, we need to do this together. You still can't, you know, brave your way through. I went up a level, I played a couple of side missions, but we need to jump back in and if you can carry me through, because you need to be rezzed.
Yes.
I would love to do that.
Yeah.
So that, and then one of my stack of shame, this is a great time of year to start working on that stack of shame. And so I started playing Assassin's Creed Origins earlier this week. Not exactly a newsflash, super late to the party, LTTP, but this is a great game. This is really, really fun.
Are we really acronyming late to the party?
Yeah.
I mean, or to be honest.
TBH, Larry. I LOL'd when. Okay. Yeah.
Great.
So,
great.
STG, Larry.
Yeah.
There's like a moment, like pretty early in the game, when you're like just riding through the dunes on your camel. And I do love that you ride on a camel. Where it's like, the scope of this game is just so much bigger than any of the kinda previous games in the series. And it's just, you know, I've never been in the middle of the desert. I know you have. You've blown things up in the desert.
I have.
As I recall. Actually, you have a lot of, you've been in many deserts.
I have. I just realized it, yeah.
Yeah, you're a real dry heat type of guy.
We launched the Xbox 360 in the middle of the desert.
Yes, it was that, and then you were in Iraq. Well, anyway, I've never been to the desert. And this is the closest I feel like I've come. And this is like a travelogue for Egypt, like making you want to go.
Well, it's interesting you say that because, you know, I think we talked about this when it launched. My sister, who's a librarian, you know, you've met Sue. She talks about how this has, when the game came out a few months ago, it sparked interest for her high school kids to come in and learn about Egypt. And it's got a function where you can go through. And there's some historical accuracies in the game.
Yeah, that's something that team has always like strived to do is sort of make sure you're almost living like a you know, the best of, you
right.
know, medieval Italy
right.
or the Middle East or whatever it might have been in previous Assassins. So, I'm very, very into it, and they changed the game enough to really mix it up, and it doesn't feel I don't have to hold a button, I don't have to hold the right bumper to run, and that works for me.
Okay, yeah. And you get a camel.
And you get a camel,
and there's
pyramids. And it comes when you whistle, so. And there's just so much. So.
Out of nowhere.
I know. The map is so big.
Yeah.
Making my way to Alexandria right now?
Could be.
Sure.
Could
Why
be.
Not? Yeah. I can't believe they put Virginia in the game, but whatever.
Well, Jeffrey.
I don't know a lot of things. Well, anyway, that's what I'm playing, of course. You know, obviously, we need to jump on some more Overwatch together.
I've been playing Sea of Thieves a little bit here. Got my drum...
Are you offline? Because I feel like, you might be.
Yeah,
because
there's a couple, games, there's a couple games I was playing that I couldn't show that I was playing. Let's see what else. Oh, I finished Unravel 2.
Oh, yeah. That was announced at E3.
Right. I came back
EA
and when I wasn't feeling well, that was just, I didn't want to play any multiplayer. So I was like, ugh. And I play it and fall asleep and wake up and solve puzzles. It's a great co-op game. If you love the original, it's more yarn.
Yarny.
We have a Yarny in the studio. You've seen him.
I have seen Yarny.
Yeah, he's held up in our studio. So played that. Did a little Fortnite because apparently I feel like
kids,
I need to.
The kids are playing all the Fortnites.
Yeah, exactly. I'm doing those dances.
Get your maybe some slurp juice will fix you up.
Flame in the Flood.
Oh yeah.
The reason I did that is because I wanted to re-download it and test out Fast Start, which is a new feature that's coming to Xbox later this year.
How fast did it start?
It fast pretty quick.
Yeah.
So this isn't using machine or learning. It basically looks at the bits and says these are the bits that are going to get you started faster.
So. I'm so bad at that game.
Wow, am I congested?
Yeah, you're like flagging in front of my eyes.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with me. Well, I don't want to sag. I want people to be happy, and so what we're gonna do?
Words, Larry. Words. Choice of words.
Oh boy.
You want that? We should get to the news.
Yeah, I would want we should get to the news and I don't have to talk. Jeffrey, what's going on? Let's go to the news desk, Jeffrey.
So we begin, as we always do, with Nintendo Switch news.
Yes.
This is where you insert record scratch here.
Did you say crossplay?
Good. So today, or you know, by the time you're hearing this, it might have been a couple of days.
Recently.
But the Bedrock version of Minecraft. This is the version that you're playing on Xbox One. It's the version that you're playing on mobile, if you're playing on iPad or whatever it might be, is now available on Nintendo Switch. So what does that mean? Well, that means you're going to be able to play together with folks on a lot of these different platforms, Xbox One, Windows 10, VR, mobile devices. It's pretty awesome. And it also means, and I actually cannot wait to try this out.
Tell me.
I can't wait to unlock an achievement on my Nintendo Switch.
Me either.
Yeah. So there is there's a ton of stuff to it that if you're wondering, what does the Bedrock version mean? Or how is this different from what I own? By the way, if you already own Minecraft on Switch, like you had bought it 6 months, a year ago, whenever it first came out, you can just re-download this. This is free.
Right.
This is no extra cost to you.
Right.
So, and you would just get it from the Nintendo eShop. But there's a lot of things that you might be wondering. And fortunately, the good folks at Minecraft over at Minecraft.net have put together an FAQ, and I'm going to link out to that in the show notes.
You will?
I will.
I don't see them in the show notes, but I assume
well,
I'll
they're
see them
going
soon.
To be there, Larry.
Okay.
It's got to update.
Okay.
This was another thing that was pretty big this week. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, Xbox One backward compatible.
Yeah.
So something that one or two people may have tweeted
at
you
game.
In the past.
Maybe.
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 And
our friends at Activision said, you know what? This probably would be a good idea.
This would be good. And I hear it runs very, very well.
I can't think of a back compat game that doesn't.
True.
Right.
So I'm stating the obvious
right,
here.
Right.
But I've just looking through the Reddits and looking through the, you know, the Eurogamers and stuff. People are pretty impressed.
Yeah, they like
how that's running.
Good.
So play it better than you remember. Here's something else to keep you busy. You would think, all right, it's E3. And when you go to E3, I'm starting to think about all the games that I want to play that aren't out yet. One of them being like Cyberpunk 2077.
See, I never saw that demo. You saw this story demo.
I will keep it brief, but everyone's been talking about it. It was, I don't know if it was like officially game of show or whatever.
But it sure but felt like it.
It sure felt like it. Yeah. It was made by CD Projekt Red, the people that brought you The Witcher,
right.
Witcher 3. Obviously, one of the very best games of generation.
These guys know how to make games.
They know how to make. They don't know just how to make games. They know how to build a world that feels real, and it feels like you're just one character in that world. Not, you know, as soon as you cross over the horizon, everything else stops. It doesn't feel like a cardboard Hollywood world. It feels
right.
like a real lived-in world. And from what I saw in Cyberpunk 2077, far beyond that, it seemed like if you were playing in a cyberpunk futuristic.
Yeah.
It's Blade Runner. It yeah. felt like you were in Blade Runner, but with better acting. Oh, hey, I just wanted to get a rise out of you, Larry.
You know what I'm doing, right?
You're unfollowing me on
no,
Twitter?
No. You know what I have here is
what?
It's interesting you say Blade Runner because my text tone for my phone is the Blade Runner sound.
I did like
the
part.
Second yeah. the second Blade Runner.
So, yeah,
you
of
know,
course.
When he calls, when he brings her in the little thing.
Oh no, I remember. It was a good movie.
Yeah.
I probably shouldn't have seen it on an airplane.
Now that's Graham texting me that he's outside. So you're gonna deliver the news, and I'm gonna go get. Graham.
All right, so
I'll be right
we
back, people.
Will continue. So while games, this is not the biggest release window for games. There's actually quite a few things to play. And one thing, if you're looking for something to play that is free, Vermintide 2. Beta is now available for download. We will, of course, link to that in the show notes. And over on Xbox Wire, the team from Fat Shark, who is creating Vermintide 2, they are going through and they put a number of different sort of tips and tricks. This is a cool looking first person medieval sort of demon hunting type of game. And I played a bit of this at GDC and we had it at E3. And now you can play it in your own living room. And eventually it's going to be coming to Xbox Game Pass. So just begin your journey today. And a few new releases. One of those is Neo Geo King of Fighters 2000. Hey, Larry's not here. It's just, all right, he's gone. We can talk about him. I think, assuming he's still recording, he has no idea. I wish I had planned what to say. And yeah, we're talking more about... I was actually just starting to wonder if we were recording. And we were just about to start talking about you. But I realized this is a one-way, like, sort of
That's
medium.
Called a monologue.
Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, joining us now, Mr. Graham Boyd. Hello, Graham.
Hi, Graham.
Hi.
Hold on a second. Let me get your microphone.
You seem to have the E3 plague as well. It's more of a malaise. Your voice is still like you've been Vegas for a month.
Oh.
That's me.
I thought I was doing quite well.
Sorry to break the news to you.
I love how you looked at me and said, you look like plague as well.
Look, we're all a little bit tired. We're not getting any younger.
I was just saying to Larry, I really hurt my leg at football last
night.
That's what I saw. You limped in here.
Limped in, yeah, like an old man. Totally.
Well, he was funny because he was limping down the hall and he was going slow. And I'm like, we have to hurry up. Jeff's doing the news all by himself.
I'm trying.
Well, while you're settling in. Now, let's talk about your football.
Okay. No.
This is the World Cup. It's going on.
There's no Blazers related. Here. Okay?
Yeah, it's Xbox related for reasons.
For the Turn 10 team.
Oh, well, there you go.
The local Redmond video games, like six aside league. So.
Oh, nice.
So, yeah, and we are unbeaten for. Well, I don't know. We've won the league for the last like 5 or 6 seasons.
Right.
Unbeaten in about 30 games.
That's pretty good.
Pretty good. But yeah, I got the worst dead leg I've ever had in my life.
What is a dead leg? What does that mean?
So, it's basically like when. Like someone's knee goes really hard and deep into your muscles.
Oh, what is that called?
A dead leg?
It's a dead leg, yeah.
I played football, so I don't remember having
getting
He wasn't playing flag football. He was playing soccer.
Yeah. I was playing soccer.
Soccer ball.
Oh, really? Okay.
That's what I was referring to, yeah.
Oh,
what position did you play?
Yeah. They called it back in the day, I wasn't a sweeper. I was a fullback.
Oh, nice. They still call it that.
Yeah, so I was back near the goal.
That's a lot of running.
A lot of running. That's when I back. Pardon me?
Up and down the wing?
Up and down. I was right in my channel, baby. Up and back and up and back.
I'm just going to move this over.
Go ahead.
I'll be able to see you.
So I do have a history. I just, you know, it's part of my life I don't talk about. You know, I used to have short little mini shorts. You've seen them.
Yeah. The style's a little longer these days.
Why don't you just come and play with us on a Wednesday night then? You might get a good game.
I would love to
get a kick in.
I might end up with a dead leg.
You're not really selling it.
But for the record, I won the tackle and we won the game. And I'd already scored my goal for the evening, so
okay. So you felt okay.
Yeah, I didn't feel
well. Welcome back. We were just talking. We talked about what we were playing, and you're welcome to talk about that. We started talking about E3 and what were. You know, it's funny. You and I we all did the show inside Xbox on Monday, and I don't think I saw you at all until maybe Wednesday night.
Yeah,
where were you?
Busy.
Yeah.
I can't even remember. The whole thing's a blur, to be honest.
Yeah, it's pretty much exactly what it was. So
Tuesday, I did a lot of Forza stuff with the Mixer team, like at the Mixer booth.
That's right, I saw you over there shooting.
Yeah, that was cool. So we did the North American unveil of the McLaren Senna, which is obviously the hero car for Forza Horizon 4, which was awesome. So we got to do that. It's the first time it's ever been unveiled in North America.
Yeah.
So that was a real kind of, you know, for me personally, it was kind of genuinely an honor and a privilege. Like, I was absolutely delighted to be asked. And that car is redonkulous. Like, it's just an unbelievably... That car's not even beautiful. It's in the traditional sense. And McLaren are really upfront about this. The form follows the function on that car, right? It looks the way it does because that makes it the fastest possible car it can
be.
And it's a road legal car, but it's ridiculously fast on the track as well.
Have you been to McLaren?
220. No.
Okay.
In the UK.
In the UK, yeah.
I have not. Yeah. They're in Woking and they've got an amazing
facility.
Yeah.
It looks like
a sort of Bond villain lair, but in the best possible way.
Right.
Why did he never
drive a McLaren?
Who?
Bond.
Oh, right. Yeah, it's a good point. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah.
I mean, I know they had the deal with
McLaren himself.
No,
and then there was BMW.
Well, they had Aston Martin, the BMW with the Pierce Brosnan in the late 90s. But I look at that. I mean, I don't know.
I guess the Aston Martin is sort of the classic. I mean, classic.
Yeah.
British.
Fair point.
Also, why didn't he drink a gin and tonic?
All right.
Gin is very English.
Fair point.
You know.
Well, he's a man of the world, isn't he? So
that's true enough.
Anyway,
so I did a lot of that, and then social stuff.
All of a sudden, the day's just there's too much. There's things on top of things. I can't be over there. We were talking about how much we enjoyed being in the Microsoft theater and all being centered there.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah, I mean, I walked by you guys and saw your workroom a couple times.
Yeah.
Now I have to. I told the story at the top of the show. You didn't get a chance to listen to it, but where were you watching our briefing from?
So yeah, this is the third time in a row that I've done this. I was on the floor, like literally on the floor in the briefing room. I was kind of doing the roadie run back and forward across the front.
Right.
Because what I tend to do during the briefing is work with someone from our team who runs the Xbox Snapchat.
Right.
So I am usually with them. We kind of plan it out in advance. We kind of, you know, have an idea of what's going to be in the show and when the big moments are that we want to capture for Snapchat.
Sure.
So we kind of plan that out in advance. And then me and this dude called Eric.
I know Eric.
There you go. We good get people. Down on the show floor and he is like proper sort of, you know, he's a photographer.
Right.
But, you know, he's running around with the phone, obviously, just for Snapchat. And I kind of run around after him saying, oh, hold on, the big moment's coming up now. Right. Start
now.
Recording.
Right.
You know, and then we kind of...
Because Snapchat, you have to, it's, you got one take.
You got one chance.
In this
yeah.
case, you got
yeah.
one take because the show's, mm-hmm. you know, you're not going to go, hey, totally. Phil, could you save it again?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, and we're trying
but look
to make,
over here.
Yeah, yeah, we're trying to like capture these highlight moments and make it, you know, look and feel as clean as it possibly can.
Sure.
And add some text on to give it some context. So it's actually like, it's a bit, it's really good fun, but it's quite stressful. And it is like, I always feel quite bad, like running about on the show floor because I don't want to distract anyone.
But you are
so
distracted.
I found myself doing that real kind of Gears of War,
right.
roadie run.
Get
back
down
and
low
forth
back.
Now what filter cool. do you put over Phil? Like, do you give him like the sort of
filter.
The halo or like the dog? Or
Phil needs no filter.
I agree.
Literally,
but you know, sometimes the
no
tools
filter.
Are there. People feel like they need to use them.
Right.
We did have little Phil stickers. For Snapchat, they
what?
Were using like a little cutout of his face that we could just dump on.
Oh, I didn't know
there's
that.
One of you as well.
There is.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Wow, this is how we have to find out.
Oh, this is. Oh,
is it like
okay.
geofenced? Like right now?
No, not at all.
Is that an unlockable?
No, I think it's just.
Just yeah. there.
I'm not sure if everyone can use it or if it's just like on our channel.
We had a yeah. We were so anyway. Jeff and I were talking about it backstage. It was just a lovely theater, lovely week. Of course,
yeah.
we did Inside Xbox on my. And you and I haven't talked about this.
What?
Now you and I have not talked about this because I didn't want to talk about it until we got it on the air, but.
I feel
terrible because if you go back and watch the video, if you go back and watch Inside Xbox, Jeffrey, when you're when you're doing the Forza interview,
all right,
there's because
yeah.
you had no idea I was going to come in with the leaves.
True.
And you had this because I went over to Ralph before the piece.
This is what's worse about it. I had no idea, but you tipped Ralph off.
Right. And I told
you
Ralph,
kept it a total surprise
I leaned over to Ralph. I said, don't worry about it. Well, I said, I'm going to have a little bit of fun here. So
and I saw you doing that as well. So I'm like, what is going on? Like, what's going to happen? It's
right.
very exciting.
Yeah. And so anyway, and then you, because you, so you have this very, because I know you're focused on doing your job because
yeah,
you're a professional.
Yeah.
You want to talk to Ralph. And I'm over there kind of throwing paper leaves in your hair yeah. or what's left of your hair. And
wow.
what? And there's.
It doesn't need to be said.
And there, anyway, you have this very like. Get away from me, kid. Beat it. You know, if you could have kicked me, you would have.
I didn't mind the cotton wool and the leaves. It was when you started spraying
misting
water all over the place. Although it was hot under those lights, so it was actually quite nice.
So it was, but go back and watch that video again, and you'll see Graham sideways glance at me like, what the hell are you doing?
Stink eye. Did you notice that it's on, the highlights are in the buildings here. Like they've got them on the big screen.
Oh, no.
The atriums, yeah.
And it's one of those highlights.
I think all the studios here and then over in my building, 37
right,
as well.
Right, right.
And that highlight is in there. So you can see you chucking stuff on my head and I'm like, what's going on?
Yeah. Well, they knew in the boot. They knew in the truck because I had tipped them off. You're the only one that didn't know.
Yes.
And then the other snafu was when, which I don't know if you were still there for this, but when Jeff was doing his interview... And with for Game Pass, and I bring in the life-size,
oh,
this
yes.
massive Game Pass,
this, yeah.
and we pull it off, and there's no code. There was a code, but we needed to pull
right.
off another piece.
That happened in slow motion, like in my mind, like we were up there for 20 minutes, because I'm pulling it back, and I pulled a little further, and I'm like, I can't believe Larry did this to me, is all I can think. Because you're talking about it forever, and I just put it back and shove it off.
And if you look at
side.
My face in this one, you'll see me look off stage to one of the marketing guys who did the thing, and I'm like, he's going, it wasn't my fault. You know, it was pretty funny.
It's a look that says, you're in trouble afterward.
I was like, what? Where is
meet me on the hill afterwards for a fight.
Anyway.
But, you know, it shows it's live, doesn't it? It's all
that's
part of the fun.
That's what we like doing live. I mean, we're doing that. We did the show live. This is April, May, June. What is this? Our third one, right? Fourth one?
That was the fourth one.
Yeah, fourth yeah, one.
Fourth
next
episode.
One will be fifth, yeah.
We're having a good time with it. It's great every month
yeah,
to
get
fun. Together with you guys and everybody else to talk about what we've got going on. And, you know, we've got This Week on Xbox every week, which is the news show. And this is kind of the magazine format. A little
yeah.
bit longer. We get yeah. a chance to spend some time and double click on Forza Horizon, which, you know, everybody loved, right?
Yeah.
I know you spent some time with it.
Oh, my God, yeah. You know, I guess I missed the what you're playing. At the moment.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And my answer was actually going to be Forza Horizon 4 because In all honesty, it's like the only game I've played over the last 3 weeks, just with E3 and everything else going on. But yeah, like I've said so many times before, like I love Forza in general. Forza Horizon in particular is just, for me, is the game.
Right, because you just drive and have fun. And
yeah, just the open world. And just like, I admire the craft and the tech in that game so much. Like, I just think Playground doing an absolutely incredible job. And they just keep getting better and better every year.
In fact, they're so good, we bought them.
Yeah, exactly. And I was so delighted to hear that news. Yeah. You know, I think, you know, every dealing I've had with that studio over the years has just been nothing but positive. They're like really great people. I think they make amazing product. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. It's like, has Horizon ever slipped or been delayed?
No, just keeps getting better.
Better and better.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Ever been anything but like absolutely on point? And then the DLCs, I think, are masterclasses.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the Hot Wheels.
And I was talking to Ralph about this as well. Like, I think the demos that they put together for like E3 and Gamescom are the pinnacle of like E3 demos. Like, it's 10 minutes. You get a great sense of like the scale of the world, the variety of the vehicles, the just the sheer like fun of the game.
There's challenges in there make you want to play it more than once.
Yeah. And they usually give, you know, if you complete all the challenges, you usually get a t-shirt or a pin badge or something like that. It's just like, I just love the way that they like, they think everything through. And then of course the cherry on the cake of it all for me, and I'm sure a lot of people over in the UK, is that it's in Britain.
Now, you've been out to their studios, right?
Yeah.
Where are they located?
So they're in Leamington Spa.
Which is where?
Which is, it's kind of the let me just get my geography right here. It's the west of England.
Okay.
Sort of down, I guess, sort of on a line with London. There's probably lots of English people screaming at me here. Yeah, it's actually like, it's over towards sort of Rare area.
Okay. Yeah, I thought it was close to there.
Yeah, when we talked to Craig, we had Craig on the show last week, and he was saying pretty much the same thing. So we've got Rare, of course, in the UK, which we've always had. We've got Playground, and then our friends at Ninja Theory, they're over in Cambridge, right?
Cambridge.
Have you been up there?
I have been up there as well.
What an amazing, I mean, I can't say enough about that game. I'm so, I mean, I'm excited about all of our new studios, but that one, only because I'm such an audio fan and what they did with the binaural audio.
Oh, Hellblade is just, you know, audio-wise, incredible, but then, you know, looks absolutely amazing, and the performance
and it's fun.
And the voice capture, the performance is there. Yeah, another amazing studio. That one was a total surprise to me. I literally had no idea until the day before, and was very secret squirrel about it. But so that it was one of those moments where I had one of those real genuine E3 thrills at something I wasn't expecting.
Right.
And then for it to be, you know, a British studio, and that studio in particular, I went up to visit them maybe 2 years ago when they were working on Disney Infinity, because they did a lot of the...
Oh, that's right. I remember your Disney Infinity passion, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Did you bring Finn up there?
Yeah, well, they invited... this is the thing. They invited Finn to go and play test a Disney Infinity expansion pack.
Right.
You know, I probably 9 months or a year before it was available. And of course, for him, that was just an incredible...
For anybody, it would be.
For me, it was amazing. And they treated Finn just like a little king. Like, it was they were so kind to him. We had an amazing time. You know, and that was way before any of this transpired. But, you know, I always thought, well, what a great studio. You got a sense that, you know, did you watch their video after the amazing video?
Yeah.
And very, like, frank and honest, I think, in that video as well about, you know... They're a small studio, and they have historically been a small studio, and, you know, they've had trouble keeping the lights on, which is what they had to do a lot.
It's a real problem for a lot of studios.
Totally. So I thought that was amazing. So
I'll link out to that so people can watch that.
Yes, I think
that's must-see TV.
You know, and when I was there, you got the sense that it's, you know, it's a small kind of, feels like a tight-knit studio, and they were just nice, genuine people. And, you know, I feel like I say that quite a lot. Like, I say that about Rare, I say it about Playground, I say it about Ninja Theory. But they really are.
Yeah.
And to your point, three beautiful places in England to have studios as well. I mean, Cambridge, obviously a really historic university town.
Sure.
Leamington Spa's a, you know, a Roman spa town.
Oh, is it?
And then Rare out in the beautiful countryside as well. So,
and if Graham's not talking about you, Finn Boyd, you know, of Seattle, Washington.
Yeah.
Treat him like a king, and you too can get up on Graham's golden list.
That's right. But yeah, just, you know, just to go back to Forza Horizon 4 very quickly, like, the fact that it's in Britain is awesome. The fact that it has...
The game takes place in, yeah.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. The fact that it has a chunk of Scotland in it, you know, Edinburgh is in the game, is like, genuinely is an emotional
Sure, of course it would be. For I mean, I can't imagine what it would be like to be able to take an expensive car and go ripping through the town where I grew up in Connecticut.
We should do the, you know, let's see if we can talk to them and say, hey, now that you guys are officially part of Microsoft, let's get that Philly to, you know,
Boston.
Connecticut, Boston sort of expansion. Yeah. Everyone's been wanting to go up I-95 during rush hour.
The Northeast Corridor. And we can go down through.
You can race the Amtrak. This game, we're practically designing it.
Yeah. Easy.
So, Ralph Fulton, we're talking to you, my friend. We've got your next, I'm sure they're already, okay, we got enough ideas.
Isn't it funny with those guys as well, that it's like, you know, Forza Horizon is a pretty, like, tried and tested formula now, but the way that they iterate on it every edition.
It is tried and tested, but it's one of those things where you look back and you're like, but of course, but nobody was doing it.
Yeah.
Right? But of course.
Well, not only that, but they add a lot of new things. Yeah. And there's some really cool new gameplay modes and how they're everyone's going to be live. There's a ton of stuff actually on IGN. So IGN has played more of this game than anyone in this room put together.
Right.
And they're rolling out feature after feature, and there's a few more hitting this week. I'm going to link out to the hub for that.
Yeah.
But if you can't wait for Forza Horizon 4 and you can't wait to learn more about it, that's a great place to go.
And they have a particularly deep article and some a great video to go with it on Seasons.
Yep.
Which, you know, really goes in depth on, you know, Seasons isn't just a cosmetic thing. It does look amazing.
Of course.
It really changes the whole kind of feel of the game, but there's so much more to it than that. So that's definitely...
Well, and that's the beauty of building on the tech from Forza Motorsport is, you know, the tires, when the temperature is out, the tires are slipperier on the road, or they stick to the road better, you know, so that obviously the seasons impact that. There's so many elements, so yeah, excited about that.
Yeah, and shout out to Forza Motorsport 7 as well, because like I think that team deserves a lot of credit for the amount of updates and new things they're adding to that game, especially at the moment. You know, they've got a ton of stuff coming out over summer, so yeah, the future is bright for Forza, I would say.
Delightful.
What was your highlight of the week?
You know, I had so many. I think it's just coming out of that briefing on that Sunday and just feeling really good about it. Yeah. Actually, there's a funny story. That was a highlight, but I haven't told you this story. Jeff and I and a bunch of the Inside Xbox folks, you couldn't make it that evening.
Right.
People, we went out to dinner.
Yeah.
And we're at dinner at the restaurant, and Jeff, you were sitting across from me.
Yes.
I believe. And I look behind Jeff. We're sitting out near the road. You know, we're sitting out al fresco.
Nice.
And I look behind him, and through the window, there's somebody staring at me.
Right.
And I look over, and it's Reggie from Nintendo.
Nice.
He was waving, so we had a little exchange. I went over and said hello to those guys, and it was a lot of fun to see.
That's good.
To see them. I mean, they're just down the street here from our campus. So
yeah,
it's just,
blows my mind.
And we had announced some. In fact, we were just talking before you came in. We announced the Switch update for Minecraft.
Yes.
So I guess what I'm saying is, you know, the highlight was the briefing. It was seeing old friends. It's just and being able to hang out and talk to the fans. I mean, you and I did so much FanFest stuff. That was unbelievable.
Yeah, that was good. Just quickly on Nintendo with the Better Together update for Minecraft.
Yeah.
There's been some nice back and forth between the Xbox social accounts and Nintendo's social accounts this morning on that. So we're all feeling very matey-matey today on that stuff.
What does that mean,
mate? It means they're not doing like IHOB and Wendy's. You know, it's the opposite of that.
Yeah.
How could you be a house of burgers, by the way? They bake pancakes.
I haven't had their burger, so I'm not gonna trash into it.
There's enough places to get burgers.
Do we even have an IHOP around here?
There's one
around here.
A Capitol Hill.
Capitol Hill?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I know exactly
right in the middle of Seattle. Yeah. So
my theory on that is that it's a publicity stunt. And they're gonna change it back.
New Coke.
By popular demand.
Right.
But everyone's talking about their burgers.
Yep, so there you go.
So now, no, I think where we're going is a pancake burger. Like, where the bun is a pancake.
See, that
I would eat that in a second.
Absolutely.
I did not eat breakfast. Well, I had a banana, but it doesn't count. That's fruit. In America, a burger with pancake is a bun. Now, that's a breakfast.
Yeah, that is a breakfast burger.
You can have that one free, Wendy's or IHOP.
Tweet them.
How did we get on this?
Does it matter? We're here, and I don't want to leave.
We got here.
I don't know how we got on this.
FanFest was amazing.
FanFest.
I think best FanFest.
Now, how much were you in FanFest? Because we were there in the morning, and then we had the briefing, and then in the afternoon. Were you there for the game show?
I wasn't. And I'm sorry. I'm really gutted that I missed your game show. Do you know why I missed it?
Why?
Because I was upstairs, and I was talking to the Rare guys. So this E3 was quite weird for me because usually I'm coming out from the UK and you sort of, you're usually on a plane with just like the whole of the UK games industry, including like people from Rare
right,
or whatever.
Right. But now that you're based over here.
Yeah, I just popped down from Seattle to LA and then everyone else sort of arrived and I was like, oh, welcome to the USA.
Right.
So it was really nice seeing the team from Rare especially. And I was upstairs in the sort of green room just gabbing with them, like the two Scottish Johns that do their video stuff and Paul as well. And we were just kind of, I lost track of time and completely missed your game show.
You heard what happened, right?
Yeah. It was really hard, right?
I ran out of questions.
All right. Wait, did you start riffing?
No, we basically did a whose line is it anyway? All right, this is where the 100 points and one last question.
Amazing.
So it was a lot of fun, but being in there with everybody and seeing the fans again is always fun. Having them in the briefing and at the show floor and, you know, in our showcase, the showcase alone. And then, you asked me my favorite things. The briefing was great. Seeing Reggie was great. Seeing friends were great. But we did something new this year that we've never done before. And that was merchandise.
Oh, yeah. God, I wondered where you're going there.
Right?
Yeah.
That was that stuff looked phenomenal.
It was really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm so happy we're doing that. And the I like the approach they've taken with it as well. Like, it's cool stuff. It's genuine.
Yeah, I'm working on stuff. So I'm, you know, they came to me months ago and said, hey, could we sell your pin?
Yeah.
So for the first time ever, the pin that you see I've given you and Jeff, you guys that we wear in videos all the time, you can now buy it yourself. They sold out of those. So they're getting those back in stock. But I'm working with them on a bunch of other items as well. Look, the reality is there's no shortage of ideas and excitement over there. So they can only do so many things and they're going to get to your ideas. They want to do it all. But if you need to go anything, gear.xbox.com, you can go over there and see what's going on. Did you get one of those bomber jackets, Jeff? Did you see those?
I did, but it was so hot. I was like, that looks great for 6 months from now. But I did get two t-shirts and... I've already
two
worn
t-shirts
them
and a microphone.
Twice. Yeah, thank
wow.
you.
Wow,
that's a
well. When you come back from E3, you've got a lot of washing and laundry to do, don't you? So
sure.
It's kind of like, okay, which t-shirts did I get at E3 that I can just wear for the next week?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, that's there's good. Some really nice stuff. They had a. I want that Gears like sort of icy looking. Actually, they had a hat.
Yeah.
That had sort of like a half omen and it was blue and that's I need.
So I got the red Gears one, the sort of Gears 5 one.
Yeah.
And then like when me and Rod were. When I was interviewing Rod on Inside Xbox, I swear to goodness we didn't plan this, but I had like a red jacket and a red...
Right, I remember that.
Yeah, and Rod was wearing a blue like sports jacket and the blue one, and we kind of look like we're in a boy band when you see the photos of it back.
I kind of do mean, look like you're in a boy band.
Not a particularly like youthful boy band, but a boy band nonetheless. Maybe like a sort of folk group or something like that.
Apparently my pin has a 4.6 rating on the store right now.
Nice, out of 10.
Out of 5.
Where could they improve? I mean, do they want like, you know?
I think people just, you know, they just, it was sold out. So.
Yeah. Oh, then a few like 1 stars in there, yeah.
It's got your, I didn't notice at first, but it's got your logo
got
on,
name the, on, it, yeah.
on the back, on,
yeah.
sort of cardboard plate.
On the,
card, well.
On the holder,
that's
yeah.
Cool.
So,
yeah,
but
nice.
We're working on some other cool stuff with them as well. So stay tuned for that. I have a lot of ideas for pins and shirts and other merchandise. So if you have any ideas, let us know.
Yeah, it's a great show. And then also I should say, like a lot of people were tweeting me about being able to get it in other countries around the world.
Yes.
And those plans are...
Absolutely going to, yeah.
This was like the E3 stuff was kind of like a rollout. And so it was available on the ground at E3 and then online, I think, in the US.
Gear.xbox.com.
I should get John or James in here. I should get those guys in here to talk. You know, I'm going to do that.
It's great for an audio format. Maybe you should have them on why don't we do a video show and they can show some stuff.
That's a good idea.
Oh, Jeffrey.
Look at this. A little live producing here for you guys.
That's why I keep you around.
This is how the magic happens.
Well done.
But it would be cool to hear from them, like the design process they went through and who they worked with and where they took their inspiration from.
Yeah.
You know, I think it would have been easy just to like put out some t-shirts with just some logos. Mm-hmm.
They didn't want to do that. They wanted to have quality stuff. I mean, they just don't want to take a $2 t-shirt, slap a logo on it and sell it for $15.
The shirts are nice and long, which I like. Because as a somewhat tall gentleman.
Oh, so long here. You're holding your hands out like they're long sleeves?
Because if I held them straight down. Well, anyway, don't look at my arms. But like when I put my arms over my head, you don't have to see my belly button. Because it's just, no one wants to see that.
No. No, I literally do not want to see that.
Yeah. All right. So, but these shirts are nice and long. I'm like, I can reach things on the top shelf all day.
I need some mind bleach. Jeff, can you get me that out of here, please?
Jeff Fit.
Yeah. Thank you. Jeff Fit. Exactly.
Anyway, we had a, so the gear thing. Well, I'll get the good idea, Jeff. Let's work on that. Let's get those guys
Let's do one in the video show.
Yeah. We'll come on to the old mixer.
Yeah.
Maybe you can join us as well.
I'd love to, yeah.
You know, there's a lot of folks have been asking us since Laura has left, what are we going to do to replace her? And I mean, I love having you on, so you're welcome to come on. We're going to figure it out.
Yeah, thanks. Well, I'm always happy to be Laura's subpar replacement.
Well, the biggest concern I had, and we talked about this when we did the show with Laura, is that, you know, the moment she left, the IQ of the show dropped about 400 points. Because Jeff and I are in here throwing poo at each other.
There's a way to tie this back into my navel, but we're not going to do that.
But yeah, you're welcome to come on anytime.
Oh, thank you.
So anyway, E3 was successful. It was a lot of fun. It was a big week for the gaming industry as a whole.
Yeah.
You know, of course, our friends at Bethesda had their event that evening. Sony did theirs. Nintendo did their event. Ubisoft had their event. EA had their event. I mean, everybody was firing on all cylinders. It was fun.
Yeah. Bethesda's event was good, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Like, I talked to Pete, like, at Inside Xbox, and I was like, mate, your conference was awesome.
Yeah. Just,
you know, seeing Elder Scrolls up there, I know it was just a tease, but
that's all I need to know.
I know, exactly.
That's all I need to know.
Skyrim was genuinely the last game that I really fell truly, madly, deeply in love with, so I cannot wait for the next.
And then they have a bunch of stuff coming into, that's now in Xbox Game Pass, Fallout 4 and Elder Scrolls Online, Tamriel Unlimited, I believe it was,
and there was
a third game.
Yeah, it was cool to have Todd on our stage as well, you know, for the first sight of Fallout 76 to be in our briefing was really nice.
I ran into Todd. I spent a lot of conversations with Todd Howard. God, I just love that guy.
He's great, isn't
he?
I don't think I've ever talked to him, but
he is so smart. He's such a fan. He told me some great stories. We were just swapping old school stories. Unfortunately, I don't want to tell him here because they're really his stories to tell. Mm-hmm. I told you one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just the nicest guy, and he just wants to make great games, and he loves coming on the Xbox stage.
Yeah. He is so funny as well. Like, his delivery.
Oh, yeah.
Like, he's not trying hard to be funny. It's just, like, the way he talks and, like, the lines he lands are just so good. I haven't watched it yet, but, you know, NoClip video? You heard of that? Danny O'Dwyer? So they've done, I think, two documentaries with Bethesda. One on, like, the history of Bethesda and one on the making of Fallout 76, which I'm reliably informed are amazing. I need to, like, settle down one night and watch them, but yeah, I can't wait to see like some behind the scenes stuff with Todd and Pete and the rest of that team.
Yeah, they're fascinating. Good stuff.
Yeah, and just a good time for video games at the moment, right? Like I was reading yesterday that May was like the best May ever. Yeah. For
well, we actually. Do you have that NPD sale number that we talked about?
Oh,
I retweeted it actually.
Oh, did you? Okay, yeah. Well, what I saw was congrats to our new coworkers, Undead Labs.
Yes.
State of Decay 2, the best selling game in the U.S. in May 2018. That's awesome.
It's great, isn't it?
Wow.
Yeah, and it is like great game as well.
Yeah,
like I've been. Remember that first weekend we were playing?
We all played together. I could use some help, by the way, because I'm stuck on a few.
I need help as well.
Yeah.
You mean that first time we played to do the capture and I had insta-die?
And you got pulled apart by the big dude.
Because at that point, Ryan was like, okay, we have everything we need now. We got the shot. Yep. Larry sacrificed his character.
And do anything for the show. You guys know that.
I think in the end, we couldn't even use it on Inside Xbox because it was too grisly.
It was too grisly, right. It was too violent.
Wow. Well, it was worth. I enjoyed.
I should get it anyway. We should just share it out on social and just say,
it's
guys,
a nice gift, isn't it?
Not safe for work.
Yeah, but that's an amazing achievement, especially with it being part of Game Pass.
Yeah,
you know, there's
some other great, you know, big games came out that month, and there's a lot of stuff. So hey, congrats to them. Great game, great result.
Yeah, and it's we still have offers on Xbox consoles. Right now.
No, we do.
Yeah, we had them on last week and they're still on this week. So
I tweeted a bunch out.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good time to get an Xbox One S or X because it's actually the first time we've had an official price cut.
Yeah. I think that may be done, but it was big. The first time we've ever done it.
So there you go. Good time.
So real quickly, I'm just going to mention a couple games coming out next week that you'll want to play if you're just picking one up. One is, I'm very excited for, is Nier Automata. Become as Gods Edition. Mm-hmm. So this game was pretty well heralded and is finally coming to Xbox platforms, the Xbox One family of devices, and very much looking forward to it. It's very very unique. There's some interesting ways that you think the game is over and it's not over, and I think you can anyway. It's one of the best reviewed games out there that's coming to Xbox. Very excited for that, and of course it's Xbox One X enhanced, 4K HDR, all of that stuff. So that's coming out next week. And also another game that was looking around and was surprised to find out is that Luminous Remastered is coming to one of the most fun puzzle games. That's coming out also next Tuesday, and it's only going to be $14.99.
Didn't you work on that on the Vita?
That was on the Vita. Was that a Vita launch
PSP.
Title or PSP?
PSP.
Yeah,
PSP,
God, right. That's like it was a PSP launch title. That's a great one, but I think there was a Vita version. And then one other game that sort of we may have missed while we were busy over at E3 that was announced. And is now actually available for pre-order and pre-download on Xbox One coming later this summer. Overcooked 2.
Yeah.
So the original Overcooked is on Xbox Game Pass. Yeah. One of the best party games, if assuming you want to yell at your party guests. And, you know, maybe you do. But just like in a four-player split screen, or not split screen, sort of shared screen couch co-op situation. That game is so good.
Yeah, it's amazing.
But it's just so, so frustrating in a good way.
It's like, it's funny and infuriating at the same time. So you're having, with the people you're playing with, you're having a great laugh, and then all of a sudden you're just having a massive fight.
What did you do?
It's great.
I was playing with my family, and we finally were getting like a routine going, and we're playing on, there's a level, in this game you're assembling hamburgers generally, or some other food stuff.
Soup.
And cutting up onions and stuff. And we were on an ice floe, like a little flat iceberg, and we finally got our system together and we put together this very complicated burger. My wife's like, I'm gonna run it out to the kitchen, and she just slides right off the edge of the ice floe into the water, and we lit into her. We're like,
the full
I
burger.
Can't believe we finally got it, and we only and we were so close to beating the level, and she just brilliant. Jumped in the water.
Wah, wah, wah.
Anyway,
great,
that's
great
that
game design
is.
In there, though, because as soon as you feel like you've got your your process down, mm-hmm. and you're all doing your thing, you've all found your role, it then chucks in something like that, or like the pirate ships that move or whatever. It's
do you play it at home with the kids?
I do, yeah.
And do they like it?
Yeah, well, me and Finn used to play it quite a lot, and yeah, we would have a right laugh with it. Absolutely. It is. It's one of those games that's actually, it's great for kids, because it's really one button, right?
Essentially.
Directional stick,
yeah,
and one button to chop, and
yeah, exactly.
Maybe a couple of buttons.
Yeah.
One to pick up and one to chop. So yeah, I'm excited to see what they do with the second one.
Yeah, well, they'll have online play, which I can't remember if the first one did, but
no, I don't think it did.
Well, Overcooked 2 will.
Nice.
So you can yell at people and they can mute you, which they probably will if they're playing with me.
Another big announcement that we had this week, which surprised everybody, this guy included, was, and this is...
Yeah, I know what you're going to say.
You can now get an Xbox, you can now get a game set for your American girl.
Oh, that's right. When I saw that tweet from you, I was very surprised.
Well, I got to tell you, it got a lot of pickup.
Yeah.
Like I saw it on, I think, was it on BuzzFeed? It was definitely on, I don't know, a bunch of other news aggregating sites. But the team came to me and said, hey, we've got this thing. I looked at it and I was like, well, this is really cool, but my audience, I don't know. These guys, I don't know. So I'm like, here we go. So I just decided to buckle up and toss it out there. And sure enough, and the people that love it, love it. And there's always going to be people that, like, what are you doing?
Yeah. Oh, there's your exclusive.
So it was, but it was, overall, it was well received. So
Yeah,
I'll link out to it.
Is there a British girl line?
No, I mean, this is part of the thing. Like, I was sort of frantically Googling American girl.
What is American?
Might not always be the best thing to do. But,
not at work.
You get a lot of Tom Petty songs.
No, we don't have, I mean, to be honest, like, I don't know the whole doll world.
Nor do I.
As, you know, I've got two boys as well. So
sure.
It's never really entered that. But yeah, it was kind of, it's really cool.
Yeah.
You know, it's nice that, we have that for whoever wants it.
Right.
That's great.
Yeah. What's funny is I saw that and I was like, oh, that looks just like my house.
Right.
My daughter, you know, just playing Overwatch, presumably yelling at someone to get on the payload.
If she was playing Overwatch, that would just be your house.
Yeah, yeah. That's exactly what it'd be. All summer long.
So
that's cool.
Anyway, it's about doing, we talked about the merchandise and the gear and, you know, bringing Xbox to other places. That has nothing to do with the, no, it's not because we don't have games. It's that's two different groups. Yeah. So we talked about that at E3 with all the acquisitions and whatnot.
Well, I saw a few people saying at E3 that, you know, you don't need to, not everything is designed for you. You know?
Yeah, that's why I looked at this. I'm like, you know what? It's not for me, but it may be for somebody, and yeah, that's all that matters. Exactly. I am not the arbiter of all things everywhere.
And it doesn't take away your enjoyment of the things that you do like.
Exactly. That's an important lesson for life in general.
Yeah.
Like, I know what I like, and I know what I don't like, and Jeff knows what I like and what I don't like.
So. Yeah, and that's all that matters.
I have to know.
Anywho, so yeah, so we're looking forward. We've got a big few months coming up. We've got Comic-Con. I don't know what we're doing there.
I don't either.
Are you going down to Comic-Con? Have you? You've been
I've
before.
I've never, ever been to Comic-Con.
Oh, wow. We should go this year.
I would absolutely love to.
Yes.
Dream come true.
Yeah. So Comic-Con will probably come up. And then following that, Gamescom. Our return to Cologne and meat sweats.
I can't. Look, here's the thing. I'm in that same position I am before Gamescom where I'm like, I could eat schnitzel every day of the week.
Amen.
And I can't wait. Curryverst and the Kulsh. And I cannot wait. Day three, I'll be singing a very different tune where I would, you know, I'm like, does anyone have a salad, please?
Yeah.
Salat.
They also have these amazing, I think they've got these, you know, here in the UK as well, but the best ones are in Germany. There's these crispy coated peanuts, like paprika flavor.
Yeah.
And you can get them in these humongous bags. And I am honestly obsessed with these things. So I basically spend the whole Gamescom week just really, really dehydrated because all I'm doing is like eating.
Where do you buy these?
Salty peanuts. Just any supermarket in Germany.
And what are they called?
They're called knickknacks.
Knickknacks. Okay.
Yeah.
I've never had that.
And there's, I've noticed like in the past few years, they've got like the big paprika bags, and now they've got different flavors as well. So they've got barbecue and sour cream and onion and all. So
all right. We need to do this. And have you been to the good gummy bear place?
No.
All right. So we're going to have a cultural exchange. Boy. I'm going to take you to Baron Company in the Köln
train station,
Hauptstadt, whatever it's called, and
my German
last name fool you. I don't know any of the words.
I was gonna say very culturally sensitive of you there.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, at least part German, just not in the brain. And anyway, they have the best gummy bears, and they are in a myriad of flavors, and like everything ranging from like, you know, boysenberry to like Kulsh beer flavored, and they're all great.
Awesome. And Germans know their gummy bears.
Yeah, so it's not even.
No.
You
can't get them out of the country. They're only in fact, I think it's even regional, aren't they?
I don't seem to see them in their particular, in any other part. I don't see them outside of like, I guess the Rhineland. But I usually bring home at least 50 euros worth.
Same.
Wow.
It is. The ladies
mango
do not
flavor.
Like, they get their little, you can try anything you want.
They don't like us.
They don't like us.
Because we come in and we're like.
We're the boorish Americans.
Yeah. Like we get, it's always the same lady, I feel like. And she just gives us a look like.
Yes. Sawa?
They're going to want a sample of everything.
She starts preemptively unscrewing everything.
Yeah, yeah. And then we're going to pick up a bunch of stuff. And then we're going to like go to the cash register and go, oh, I didn't see that one.
Right.
I got to get that one. And,
right.
Ah, they love you.
Well,
okay. Well, I'll bring the salty, crispy peanuts. You bring the gummy bears. We'll just put them all into a big bowl together.
Yes.
Get stuck in.
So we're gonna. I think we're doing an inside Xbox there, from what I understand. So
yeah, I'm really excited about that. Gamescom's great. Like it's.
Oh, I didn't get to go last year because my daughter was being born.
Right.
Yeah. I was in the middle of that
so
super
this is
secret.
The big return.
This is the triumphant return because you and I have many, many, many wonderful memories. We did our first esports before esports was a thing.
That's right. Yeah.
Right. We did our first Call of Duty things
stuff.
There.
Yeah. That was
we've done a lot of things there. It's just I love working with those guys.
Yeah.
So
Gamescom's great.
So
like E3 is really, really cool. Gamescom has a nice sort of. Like community and fan feel about it.
It's also epically huge.
Yeah.
And just in terms of the amount of people that go there and the venue.
Yeah.
Right. It's
on a different scale.
It's on every way.
But it's fun. And I also find it's like, I get the chance to play a lot more games at Gamescom than I do at E3.
Right.
E3 always tends to be, it's quite rush, rush, rush. And it's, you know, it's sometimes hard to like just, you know, get access to a game to play it because it's so busy and everything. Whereas Gamescom, there's usually a little bit more time and flexibility. So I really
and the games
it.
Are further along.
Yes. Yeah.
Like, I'm assuming, I usually hunt down FIFA. It usually has a pretty big presence there.
Yeah.
you know, Peter Schmeichel, I'm sure, will be there or something like that.
Yeah, and yeah.
Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. So,
well, unfortunately, we're not going on a cruise this year.
Well,
not that I know of.
Never say never.
You and I in our shorts.
That was fun, isn't it?
God, it was hot that day.
Yeah. Well, it's always hot, isn't it?
But this was 2 or 3 years ago when it was miserable.
I was there at that time too. Yeah,
you remember that? Oh boy,
yeah, it's just like soupy.
Yeah, yeah,
soupy heat.
Yeah. All right. Gamescom, and then all of a sudden we're in the fall and all these big games are coming out. So
it's wild, isn't it? Time goes by so quick.
All right, Jeffrey, what do you got there? Do you have anything?
I've given more than I should.
I think we've overstayed our welcome. We're in just about an hour here. It's been thank you for joining us for the past 45 minutes. No, you're busy.
We're good.
Other bits and pieces.
We got the housekeeping out of the way.
We're doing good. We'll try to work on the next show, maybe have a video show, because they just built a new studio here for Mixer.
Oh, we got to christen that.
Yeah, you know what? That's when we'll bring those guys on.
Yeah.
So we'll work on that right now.
I will talk to James and John.
Yeah.
All right. Till next time. Do you have anything you want to say?
Is that your stomach growling?
Is that my stomach?
I heard that from here.
Wow.
I apologize.
It's time for lunch.
I believe it's lunchtime. My body is dictating that.
Your body is ready.
All right, Graham.
Nothing else from me, Larry.
They can find you on Twitter at
AC Bongos.
Yeah.
And everywhere else as well, really.
Is that true?
Instagram, Xbox Live. I mean, what else is there? What
else? Orkut.
Snapchat, apparently.
VK.
MySpace.
Yeah.
VK?
Yeah.
No, how do you know about VK?
I'm also ethnically Russian. Yeah. Yeah.
I did not know you were.
If there's a social network, I will find.
I did not know you. Yeah. Okay. All right, you find Jeff Rubenstein, who also takes the complaints for the show on.
Yes, at Jeff Rubenstein. I need to make a complaint desk on Twitter.
And you can find me at Major Nelson. All right, guys, we're going to run. We'll talk to you next time. Maybe we'll see you next time on Mixer, right?
We should do that.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye.